What's up and welcome to Gift Magum BBA channel. Today we're going to talk about make money online watching YouTube videos available worldwide. If you ever find yourself wishing you could get paid to watch videos online, we've got some good news for you. You can. Here's how. Making money from watching videos is a lot easier than you think, and considering you'll likely be spending plenty of time watching films, clips and ads online. Anyway, it's such an easy way to earn some extra cash in such a spare time. In an ideal way to make money alongside similar ventures like running a YouTube account, plus all the video related work experience could hugely boost your CV and help you get a job related to film, TV or digital media. There are loads of ways to watch videos for money, and we'll go through the best options here. Although you might not become a millionaire watching videos, we happen to know of other ways you can. Here's the best ways to watch videos and earn money. Number one, watch videos for cash on Swagbox. If you haven't already, we recommend signing up for Swagbox to start earning rewards for watching videos, surfing the web and completing surveys. The types of videos you'll be shown on Swagbox will vary, but you can expect plenty of short clips like ads, news content and viral videos. By watching videos on the site, you might not earn huge amounts of money or Swagbox points, aka SB, but it's such an easy way, you definitely think it's worth trying. Plus, when you use Swagbox alongside the other options in this list, your earnings will quickly add up. Write subtitles for films as a freelancer. Particularly, if you are looking to build your CV with film-related experience, it's definitely worth thinking about writing subtitles for videos online on a freelance basis. Often, video content creators will look for freelancers who can help write up subtitles for their films, perhaps to make more accessible for people with hearing loss, or to upload transcripts on posting YouTube videos. As subtitles and transcripts can be quite time consuming to write, video makers may look for freelancers to do this for them, which is where you come in. On sites like Fiverr, you can find freelancers offering to write video subtitles for a fee. Have a look at what other freelancers are charging for an idea of prices, and be sure to post rates that you think are fair but competitive. As a guideline, though, we've seen freelancers on Fiverr often starting their rates at £4.16 to write subtitles. Bonus, if you speak another language, this is even better. You can charge extra to translate videos on a freelance basis. Not to mention that it's bound to impress future employers. Number three, make money watching videos on Inbox Pounds. Inbox Pounds works in a similar way to Swagbox, letting you earn cash for super simple things like watching videos and taking surveys. Again, you might not make big money on here, but the more tasks you do alongside watching videos, the more money you can make. Even reading Inbox Pounds deals emails or searching the internet on their search page can earn you cash. You can sign up to Inbox Pounds here. Number four, become a film and actor. If you're hoping to make a living from watching videos, becoming a film or TV reviewer is probably the best and most established way of doing so. It's by no means easy to reach the point of writing about videos as a full-time job, but with hard work, dedication, and a strong grasp of the written word, you can do it. Film and TV criticism are a very competitive lines of work. So particularly, you are thinking about writing on a freelance basis, You need to start off by charging lower rates to reflect your level of experience. But remember, you deserve to be paid for your work. So don't accept payments lower than you think is fair. Just because you're starting out to prepare for full-time as a film or TV critic, it's worth looking for into internships to boost your CV. Unfortunately, not all journalism internships pay well, or at all in some cases, but check out the press pad for help with accommodation during internship placements. And if you do find yourself on an unpaid internship, our guide to supporting yourself financially during the placement can help. Once you start to build up your portfolio of reviews and make a name for yourself, you can gradually increase your rates and take on bigger commissions. Start getting commissioned for film or TV reviews. As a freelance, it was setting up a blog to showcase your writing style and talent. Then, look for commission editors or relevant publications. Reach out to them directly, addressing them by their name in emails, pitching them your idea. At the end of your pitch, link to your blog or portfolio's website so they can see what you can do. Be confident with your article ideas, keep pitches concise, and do not be disheartened by rejections. Keep going, and you might just become the next Mark Kermode. Number 5. Watch videos, movie trailers, and more for money on Irazo. Irazo is another rewards site that lets you earn money, earn points for doing loads of very easy things like watching interesting videos, playing games, and answering survey questions. The videos include short films, cooking tutorials, movie trailers, app adverts, and more. All you need to do is watch them and you can earn Irazo points. Then, once you've earned 3,000 points, you can claim your first reward. The rewards on this site include a selection of vouchers as well as cash paid through PayPal. Plus, you can get extra 500 points when signing up for Irazo here. Number 6. Take part in paid psychological studies. If you're interested in taking part in psychological and behavioral studies, this could be a good way to make money from watching videos. The amount you can get in compensation for doing psychological studies, in a way, will vary massively, depending on the type of trial and how much it costs and lasts. But you could receive as much as £100 for your free time. But please note, we recommend only signing up for studies you genuinely want to do them, rather than simply as a way of making money. Depending on the nature of the study, there's a potential for them to be emotional or mentally challenging. So only take part in ones you are comfortable with. As with clinical trials, it's important to focus on trusted organizations when signing up for psychological studies. When looking for legitimate paid psychology trials, we recommend focusing on studies at universities. First, get in touch with the psychology department at your uni to see if there are any upcoming studies you could get involved in. This will be the best and easiest way to take part in one. But if that's not possible, you could look into studies at other universities to focus your search. Try typing university name, psychological trials, into Google, as this will come up with relevant pages of the uni website. There you'll find call outs for studies, trial participants, and guidance on how to apply. Or you could always contact the university psychology department directly, either on phone or by email, to find out more about the upcoming studies. Often universities will say that they are looking for volunteers for the studies, but These opportunities will typically still include some of the compensated either in cash or vouchers for your time and expenses. That was all for today. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like and don't forget to comment.